Welcome back to my channel. I want to talk about a very profound topic today. What do your Instagram followers do? I know this is kind of a weird question. Yesterday, I was talking to a Chinese artist who currently works and lives in Canada. She told me that she wanted to start her art career again from zero as she just relocated herself and it's a new environment, a new continent. And also she wanted to start a not-for-profit association helping artists like her. And I found her project very interesting, very exciting, and I wanted to help her. So I looked into her communication. I realized that she doesn't have a website. She doesn't have an Instagram account. So I told her to go ahead and get one. And she came back to me with this very profound question. What is this Instagram thing? What do the Instagram followers do? And I was like, it caught me completely off guard. And if you answer it very simply, it's very simple. If you answer it very profound, it can be very complicated. It's socioeconomic, it's about art, meaning of life, and the relationship between people. It is just like so complicated. I tried to give her the simple answer, so I immediately wrote back to her giving her three reasons why she should have an Instagram account. Number one, it is a free way to promote your art. It's not only free but also great. Instead of paying for radio, television, other website to promote your art, you have this fan base. You can push the upcoming events, your new works directly to the phones of your fans, and you can have immediate feedback, and is a very intimate relationship. It's a very, also very economic way to market your art and your association. Number two, you can convert your fans into your customers and cutting out the middleman, the gallerist, and you're not paying 50% commission to anybody. All the money goes directly to your pocket, so it's amazing. It's a great way to do the transaction. Number three, you can have a supportive community of your art, of your artists, and you can get support both emotionally, practically, and also financially. You can have Kickstarter campaigns, GoFundMe, Indiegogo, you can have Patreon to have this monthly income, and you can fund projects that normally you couldn't afford, which gives you a lot of possibility. Like, it opens a gate completely to a new world, to a new level. So those are the three reasons I gave her. As I was texting her back, I realized one thing. Come on, like, she was not born yesterday. She had traveled to different continents, and she had lived in different parts of the world, and she had social media in China. We were chatting through a social media, you know, WeChat, so of course she knew what was social media. She knew exactly the benefits of having social media followings. What she really meant could be her analogy behind her question. It's not necessary. It's not like worth your energy to get following so that you can be successful. This is really profound, because think about it, you don't really need social media. Before social media, we had successful artists, we had old masters, contemporary masters, and before Instagram, there were artists, of course. But looking at this, I would say it's not about the Instagram or the Facebook or the YouTube. It's not about online following. It's about creating a following. It can be an old style following, right? It can be really like Jesus had 12 followers, and with these 12 followers, he went around the world and he made a lot of changes and influenced a lot of lives, and he did that with his followers, with the following he had. So it's very important to be able to have other people who believe in your message, in your cause, in your ideas, and to help you fulfill your objectives. It's very important to get help, because you can't do everything alone. No matter how great, how creative you are, it's not possible. You have 24 hours a day. You need the time for your art. It's better to invest the time to create a following, so they will do the work for you. So you just emit a message using a fraction of your time, and your followers will be there to like promote this message, to broadcast this message, and from there on. So it's very, very important to have a following. But do you need a huge following? No, I don't think you need a huge following in order to achieve what you want to achieve. Instead, you need to have quality followers. So quality over quantity is definitely what I believe. It's better to have 100 diehard fans than 1,000 or 10,000 not so engaged fans. So the quality is about the level of commitment, engagement, and also about the relevance. Like if they are art lovers, collectors, gallerists, they're more important than just random passersby who saw your account, cool art, click like, click follow. Of course, it's better to have this quality. Quality. When I say quality, I don't want to discriminate, but what I mean is relevant in terms of quality. How to have quality followers? I have talked about this throughout different videos I have made, but again, because it's so important, I think it's worth it to touch on this topic again. Number one, in order to have quality followers, you need to have quality content. That is quality image, quality videos, quality stories. You need to bring that high resolution, you know, of course, you know, you need to create pleasing image that is technically good. And then you need to consistently deliver this, not once in 3 months, but constantly. You can make yourself a action plan, how much you want to spend, what is the quality you want to arrive, the matrix you want to hit, the target. So work it out within your own capacity and see how you want to do that. So quality content is definitely very important. It's the fundamental method to attract quality followers. Number two, quality hashtags. I think hashtags are overused and underrated. Like people just throw a lot of hashtags all over the place. You can have up to 30 hashtags and you just use 30. Not a good idea. It's better to have relevant hashtags. You can do your research to see which hashtags are trending, which are relevant to your niche, and make sure you use the cross-niche hashtags. For example, you're painting watercolor. It's not a good idea to hashtag art, hashtag painting, hashtag watercolor. Your followers might not be looking hashtag watercolor. Maybe they're looking for the content. Maybe you're painting animals. They're looking for cat, dogs. They're looking for boudoir. They're looking for bandage. I mean, just hashtag the niche, the content, the thing that you think that attracts your quality followers. Do that. I think it's a cliche, but less is more is very accurate in this sense. Number three, create quality conversations. It is very important not to just to say, like, you know, like to put the butter on the bread. I don't know, because I'm lactose intolerant. I don't put butter, so I don't know if it's the right analogy. Maybe your followers will say, cool art, you know, inspirational, creative, you know, how great your channel is, love it. You can come back with more engaging, more profound conversation, like ask them what they're doing with their lives. Ask them what is the thing they really want to see, what message they see in your art. Have this intellectual conversation with them. If you don't want to go intellectual, of course, you can go personal. Like, be interested, genuinely interested in their lives so you can serve them better. Understand your audience, create a conversation based on your understanding, so that you can deepen this understanding, and once you understand them, you can service them better, you can attract them better, you can engage better, so that you can have more and more relevant followers. Because they are engaging in this deep personal level with you, they will more likely to remember you and talk to their friends about you, and you gain more, you know, word of mouth following this way. And also the algorithm will reward you. If you have more engaged community, your content will be more prioritized, will be featured, will be on top compared to a huge channel whose followers are not so active. Imagine you have 10,000 followers and 1,000 of the 10,000 are constantly engaging, posting, commenting, liking, sharing. That's great. Another account might have 50, 100,000 followers, but their followers are not so engaged. Even though you have less followers than huge accounts, famous artists, because your followers are more engaged, you'll be promoted, you'll be favored. Again, it's not about how many followers you have, it's about who they are. And who they are, it depends on what kind of art you make. So again, you have to work on your art and then work on the promotion of your art. So social media is not a shortcut to becoming celebrity, to becoming famous. There are many ways you can become successful. Working with institutions, working with schools, working with the market, using gallerists, or working on your own using social media. Social media is just one of the ways, and it's not easier than any other way. So you have to, of course, put in the work using all the tools possible, consistently creating quality content so that you can reach your audience, quality followers. It's not easy. At the first half a year, I had more videos than the number of followers I had on YouTube. And I found it even ridiculous, and I started thinking to myself, you know, is this social media important because I have put in the work and I don't see the results? But I think now things are starting to look better. I'm sharing along the way my experience with the journey I have working on social media. So if you have any questions or if you want to share your story, I would love to hear back from you. You know, how long did it take you to get the followers that you desire, and how is your community? Do you have a lot of followers? Do you have a lot of engaged followers? Who they are? Do you know them? I would love to hear that. And thank you for your time listening to me, and see you in the next video.